Hi, I'm Denver.
And I'm Sarge.
And you're watching Battle Gamer News.
Today we're reviewing Call of Juarez Bound in Blood.
Call of Juarez Bound in Blood follows the McCall brothers in their various adventures that took place before the first Call of Juarez.
Thomas and Ray begin as simple soldiers in the Confederate Army, but soon abandon the Army to defend their home.
Upon seeing that their home has been burnt to the ground, they join up with their younger brother William, and spend the rest of the game on the run from their former Confederate commander, and searching for gold to rebuild their family home.
The story is mostly told through cutscenes, and at the beginning and end of each chapter, as well as through a few endgame events.
Although the characters are by no means heroes, the game does a good job of developing the two main characters.
There's a lot of banter between the brothers, which shows their personality, and by the end of the game, you really feel like you know them.
The game does a good job of making you feel connected to the brothers, despite their lawlessness and bad character traits.
The graphics for the game are for the most part exceptional.
The character models look fantastic, and there's a lot of attention in the environments, right down to the spiders crawling up the tree or a butterfly flying by.
Unfortunately, the animations in a lot of the cutscenes are stiff and unrealistic. The mouth animations are off a lot of the time as well.
The environments are well made and varied. You really get a feel of an authentic Southern Western.
There are some real standout moments, like when you're walking through the forest or riding down the river, where you really see how nice the graphics are.
The gameplay of Call of Juarez Bound in Blood is that of a first-person shooter, but with a Western twist.
You're given a variety of weapons, including pistols, shotguns, and rifles. There are no submachine guns to be found.
Most of the levels have you fighting your way from point A to point B with your brother, and can be pretty basic.
There are, however, two levels where there's a more open world theme. You can pick up jobs via wanted posters to earn some cash and buy new weapons. It makes me wish the whole game was like that.
One gripe I had with the game is that it's set up with two brothers fighting together, so it seems naturally that there should have been a co-op mode, but there's none to be found.
If you get enough kills in a period of time, you can go into concentration mode, which allows you to temporarily slow down time to lock on and kill enemies.
Even with all of your advantages, the game can be quite challenging, but at least the game is forgiving and usually you don't spawn too far back.
There's a decent multiplayer mode with a class system, but the games take way too long to find players.
There's a pretty cool mode in multiplayer called Western Legends that allows you to reenact actual robberies that took place in the Old West. Overall, I really liked Call of Juarez Bound in Blood, and if you're looking for a good shooter with strong story elements, Call of Juarez is definitely worth looking at, so I'm giving it an 8 out of 10.
I really liked how the graphics looked, and when you add in a good multiplayer mode, you're looking at a good game. I give it an 8 out of 10.
It looks like we're giving Call of Juarez Bound in Blood an 8 out of 10. Thanks for watching Battle Gamer News. Subscribe and check back every week for more game reviews.